Hello everyone, welcome back to the second episode of my tutorial series on Broadback Management System. In the previous episode, we have successfully designed homepage for our application, and in this episode, we will create database for our application. So without further ado, let's move to our tutorial. In order to create database for our application, I'll be using Microsoft SQL Server 2014. You can use any version of MS SQL Server. If you haven't installed MS SQL Server yet, then you need to download and install MS SQL Server. I'll put the link for SQL Server Express, which is lightweight than MS SQL Server. So I'll go to my MS SQL Server and open my MS SQL Server Management Studio. I have already pinned in my taskbar, so I'll just click on the icon and open MS SQL Server Management Studio. So this is it. Now we need to connect our database engine, and for server name we can give local inside a small bracket or parenthesis, just type local. And for authentication mode, you can select Windows authentication and click on connect to connect our database engine. Now in order to create our database for Broadback Management System, just expand the databases by clicking on plus, and then here right click on databases and click on new database, and here in database name just give the name of the database. For now I'll give Broadback Management for M capital System, and then just click on OK. So here we have created database for our application. Now inside this application we will have only two modules. They are user module and the donor module. User module will contain the detail of user who will handle the application or manage the application, and another module will be donor module, and this will contain the details of the donors. So we'll need to create two tables inside this database for user and donor. So go to the tables and expand the tables folder here, and just right click on tables and click on new and click on table, and then we will need to specify columns for our table. So first table will be table users. So the first column will be user underscore ID. Its data type will be integer, and allow null will not allow null values. So I'll just remove the checkbox. And the second one will be username, and it will be varchar and varchar, and I'll give its length to 50. I think 50 is enough for now. And another one is email, and it will be of an varchar data type, and its length will be 150. I'm giving 150 for now. And another one is password will be of an varchar data type, and it will also be of length 150. And another one is full name, and it will also be of data type and varchar, and its length will also be 150. And another one is contact, and it will also be of data type and varchar, since the contact number or telephone number might consist of character like minus, parenthesis, extra. We are giving its data type to varchar, and its length will be 20. I think 20 is enough for telephone number. And another one is address, it will be of an varchar data type, and its length will be 250 is enough. And another one will be added underscore date, and it will be of data type. And the last one will be image name. In this application, we will also be uploading images for users as well as donors. So I will create a new column for image as well. So this will be image underscore name, and its data type will be an varchar, and its length will be, I think 50 is enough. So I'll just give 50 for now. If we need longer than that, then we can make changes later. So this is it. These columns are enough for users table. So let's save it by clicking Ctrl and yes, Ctrl and S, and let's give a name of the table. It will be TBL underscore users, and let's click on OK. So we have successfully created a table for users. Before moving into another table, let's specify the primary key for this table as well. And the primary key will be user ID. So let's click here for user ID and right click here and click on set primary key. Similarly, I also want to create an auto-generated ID for user which will be unique. For that, so select the column user ID and go to the column properties here. Just scroll down and just go to identity specification and double click on it. It will have is identity here. Just double click on is identity or just select yes instead of no, and it will create an auto increment for our user ID which will generate a unique and incremental value for our user ID, and it will start from 1. So this is it. We have successfully created a table for users. Similarly, we need to create another table for donors as well. Let's go to the table inside Blood Bank Management System database and let's refresh it so that we can see a table users. Now let's make another table for our donors as well. So just right click on tables and click on new and then click on table, and the first column will be donor ID. It will be of data type integer. We will not allow null values. And second one will be first underscore name. Its data type will be nvarchar. Nvarchar, its length will be, I think 50 is enough. And another one will be last name. Its data type will be nvarchar. 50 is enough. And another one is email. It will be of nvarchar data type. Length will be 150. Another column will be contact. Its data type is nvarchar and length will be 20, and 20 is enough. Similarly, we have gender column. Then gender column, its data type will be nvarchar. Length will be 10. 10 is enough. And after gender we have address. It will be of an varchar data type, and address will be, let's give it 250 length. And after address we have blood group. Blood group column, and its data type will be an varchar, and its length will be 10. 10 is enough. And similarly we need to add add date. It will be of date time data type. Another one will be a image name column. Name, it will be nvarchar, and 50 is enough for now. And the last one will be added by. Basically this is a foreign key. It will be of integer data type. It will be the ID of the user from user table who added the particular donor. So this is a foreign key. As we have did in our users table, we need to set a primary key. So let's go to the first column, which is donor ID, and right click here and click on set primary key to set a primary key. And similarly, we also need to set a auto increment. For that, click on the donor ID column. Go to column properties and search for identity specification, and double click on identity specification and double click on is identity. So it will make our donor ID as auto increment and unique. Now let's save our table. To save it, press Ctrl and yes, and let's give a table name. It will be TBL underscore donors, and click on OK. So this is it guys. We have successfully created a database and tables for users as well as donors, and in the next episode we will connect this database with our application in Visual Studio. So thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And if you have any confusion related to this video, then don't forget to comment. I'll reply as soon as possible. Thank you, see you soon, bye bye.